Hello, this is Dio. Today, I will tell you about the basic concept of implant planning guide. The first chapter is about the method to position the implant. The second is about the height of the guide. And third is about the size of the implant. These are the parts that are in the first chapter. To locate the implant, the anatomical structure in the oral cavity is very important. In the case of maxillary bone, there may be a movement of the leftover bone based on the maxillary sinus location, which is here. Therefore, maxillary sinus, or in the case of maxillary anterior, nasopalatine nerve may be the important anatomical structure. For the mandibular bone, the location of the alveolar nerve and the mental foramen will be most important. If the patient was left for a long time without any teeth, they might only have the basal bone left due to absorption of the alveolar bone. Alveolar bone absorption means that available bone for implant placement has been absorbed, so there may only be residual bone very near the alveolar nerve. As you can see in the video, in the implant studio, there is a safety distance around the fixture. The safety distance around the side of the implant is 1.5 millimeters, and the safety distance below the implant is 2 millimeters. This is because on the mandibular bone, you need at least 2 millimeters safety distance from the alveolar nerve, and you can place the implant based on this setting. You can see the green line around the implant, which is the safety distance. When the line turns red, it means that something is in the way, such as alveolar nerve, other implants, or neighboring tooth. When placing the implant, the safety distance between the implant and the tooth is 1.5 millimeters, and the safety distance between two implants is 3 millimeters. You have to select the right place to place the implant, knowing all this. If there isn't enough safety distance, you must be aware of the bone loss between two implants or between implant and tooth. If the implant is fully osseointegrated, you can consider it as a natural tooth. This means that if the implant is placed a long time ago and is fully osseointegrated, you can give a safety distance of only 1.5 rather than 3 millimeters. When you are planning the implant location, there must be 1 millimeter of residual bone left on the labial and buccal side in the coronal view. When arranging the tooth virtually, the implant should be designed so that implant hole is located on the central groove. This can be helpful in manufacturing prosthesis that can be maintained for a long time when seating it later on. Additionally, it has to be planned so that implant is placed within the range of attached gingiva at the most. The attached gingiva plays an important role for the implant and natural teeth. If the implant is positioned by only considering the bone structure, and not considering the attached gingiva, there is high possibility of placing the implant towards the buccal side. If this happens, it will be difficult to produce prosthesis and maintain the health of mucous membrane around the implant. In the case of teeth in the posterior area, it must be planned with the implant that can withstand the masticatory force and has sufficient bone-to-implant contact surface. In addition, if the fixture diameter is wide, you can choose a shorter implant. But if the diameter is narrow, the implant has to be long, so it has enough surface area for osseointegration. If osteogenesis is incomplete at the tooth extraction site, positioning the implant can be difficult. In such case, it is possible to set the implant position according to the height of the adjacent alveolar bone. Also, if the screw thread is exposed due to narrow ridge and patient has thick gingiva, you can plan the implant so that the screw thread can be exposed on the palatal side. However, if you are planning to perform GBR by any chance, you should plan it to have the screw thread exposed on the buccal side. If the conditions are poor for placing an implant, doctor's opinion may be necessary for diagnosis. In the photo, if you see from the buccal lingual side, which is the coronal view, if the bone width is narrow on the upper area, you can delete the upper alveolar bone to obtain bone width and position the implant. In this case, you have to keep in mind that the implant can be placed deeper than you expect, and you should design accordingly. Currently, if a substantial amount of bone needs to be deleted, the Dionabi team adds comments on the amount of bone that needs to be deleted by measuring the value in millimeters. As you can see here, the Dionabi team add 2.9 millimeters to delete. Now let's look at the height of the guide. These are the parts in the second chapter. The height of the guide needs to be as low as possible in the posterior area. If the guide is tall, accuracy of the drill decreases and the angle may go askew, so it needs to be produced as low as possible. If the guide is tall, the patient needs to open the mouth wider during the procedure, which is very painful and it will also make drilling more difficult. Even for the convenience of the surgery, height of the surgical guides needs to be designed as low as possible. Thicker gingiva requires higher guides and higher offsets. In this case, the application of higher offset is difficult due to the patient having a small mouth. If only about 1 millimeter needs to be lowered, there is a method to lower the height of the guide, which is purposely cutting a portion of gingiva in the scan data. The gingiva can be pressed down when seating the guide. The pressure of about 1 millimeter does not affect the guide's height, but it is best to check the offset under the CT before proceeding with the surgery. In the third chapter, we will look at the size of the implants that can be placed in each tooth. In the case of anterior teeth in the maxillary, these are the largest teeth among the incisors with big roots next to the canine teeth. Therefore, it is advisable to plan and place the fixtures with diameter of 3.8 millimeters up to 4 millimeters if there is enough bone width. In terms of the length, more than 11.5 millimeter is recommended in general. Nonetheless, there are also numerous cases where the bone is narrow because the bone was absorbed after the tooth was lost and it was left toothless for a long time. In such cases, the size of the fixture can be changed depending on the situation. In the case of mandibular anterior teeth, there are many cases of narrow bone width. As such, it is recommended to plan with average narrow-sized implant. Since premolar tooth in the maxillary is a posterior tooth that affects occlusion, it obviously needs to be planned with diameter of more than the regular size of 3.8 millimeters and length of more than 10 millimeters. However, the length can be shorter if nasal cavity or maxillary sinus is in the vicinity. The length of the fixture can even be longer by lifting the maxillary sinus. premolar tooth in the mandibular can be planned with diameter of more than 3.8 millimeters and length of less than 11.5 millimeters, depending on the bone width and distance from the alveolar nerve. In the case of molar tooth in the maxillary, it is operated with guide types of 45-10 or 50-10 in general. There are cases of using a fixture with a shorter length to avoid sinus lift. In such cases, fixture must be placed by selecting the size that includes large surface area. In the case of posterior tooth in the maxillary, there is more limitation in opening with longer length, thereby generating difficulties in drilling or placing. As such, it is also important to know that the limitation in opening can become more severe if the opposing teeth are extruded. Although implant is generally placed with a guide type of 45-10 and 50-10 in the case of molar tooth in the mandibular, the distance from the alveolar nerve is the most important factor. Therefore, the length is adjusted in planning stage if the nerve is close by. Similarly, in the case of the molar tooth in the mandibular, limitation in the opening can occur if the opposing teeth are extruded. This is it for today. Thank you for listening. This was The O.